Hello everybody, and thank you for coming back to the channel on this yet another cold and misty morning. So I don't want to give the impression that they're living in a cloud always. It's not true. It's just very early and the sun hasn't yet managed to penetrate through the fog. The cornfield is still there, which is scary. So I'm now surrounded by a scary cornfield and a scary cloud. But I want to anyhow try it because I've been wanting to test out the new improvements I've done to the mosquito. As you see, it looks horrible, but I've put on a layer of lacquer, which I hope has made it a bit more watertight and that the tissue will not wrinkle so much when flying. You see that the camouflage looks very bad. The canopy actually has melted down a little bit, so I have to paint it over. So that's not very pretty, but I want to try also the flying. If you notice, I've also retrofitted some landing gear. I will be removing it. I think this one will be better, but I will be removing it for the flight. If I see it goes very well, then I might try to take off on it, but I don't think that'll happen. And what else? What else do we have? Yes, and I fixed one of the motors. If you remember from the last time, one of the motors was loose, so I've glued it up again. And let's see how that goes. And I might even try again the Spitfire, which is so far the best flying model that I've built, but of course it's a Guillo's design, it's not that I designed it or anything. So let me put up the cameras and let's see how it goes on. So here's the mosquito. I forgot one of the holders for the cameras, so actually for the phone camera, this one, so I won't be able to film as usual. So let's see if I can pull it off somehow. So let's see. I'm not sure if I managed to get that with the head camera, but I kind of cartwheeled, but it did fly a while, and now I see I've lost an aileron, one of my typical things. Ah, it's hanging down under there. So let's see how this goes, but it did fly, so let's see if I can get it to fly again and not just end the day like this. So the first flight was kind of okay, I would say. Still sluggish to control, but I could control it. I didn't even need full power on the engines, which is good, so I don't get overheated and the battery lasts a bit longer. But then on the second launch I did, I kind of lost control and I cartwheeled into the concrete. And let's see if I haven't damaged anything too badly, and let's see if it flies again. I do notice that it's getting sticky, so even that layer of lacquer is maybe not enough, because it's getting sticky where I glue the tissue on with a stick glue, or the glue stick, then it does get sticky. So that might also be an issue for the control surfaces. So I'll do another try at least. So it was flying kind of okay. I could control it. I did some nice low passes. I'm not sure how much of that I managed to catch on camera. Then I I saw I could not turn it very much, and I was going into my dreaded cornfield, so I cut off the power, and it crashed with an ugly sound. I didn't see it actually hit the ground, but I think it did cartwheel, but at least I got it here on the very edge of the cornfield. So let's see if we can fly again. I'll try it. Come back here, come back. Don't stay there. It seems to be in one piece, so let's try it once more and then we go maybe to the Spitfire. So I'm calling it a day for the mosquito. It did fly. The last few flights it didn't really work too much, and I don't want to push it as probably the battery's already been drained. I noticed, and I'm not sure on what crash it was, that this landing gear strut, I don't know if you can see there, that has come loose. It's broken, maybe one of the crashes on the concrete. So I'm not going to put the landing gear in anymore, which is a pity because it looks good in it, even if it isn't flying it. But I would say the lacquer has helped. The wrinkling has been reduced significantly. It does fly. It does need full power all the time. It is still tail heavy. I still have to push down on the elevator quite a lot so that it keeps hold, and I do run a constant risk of stalling. But overall, still quite happy with it. I'll try to fix it up, and weather permitting and cornfield not scaring, I'll try it again. I think the mosquito is going to be one of my classics, I think. Now let's go to the Spitfire. So as I mentioned before, the Spitfire is my most successful model. It's the first RC conversion I did, and it did crash a lot, and I fixed it up a lot. I'm going to fly now without the battery hatch, because last time I flew it, I didn't record it, but I flew it and it got stuck because of this issue with the humidity and the glue. So I'm going to just leave it without the battery hatch on. I'll just put the battery in. The setup is the same as the P51. As you see, this does get a bit wrinkly. I believe I did use dope on this one originally, so it's a bit better. So whatever I have on it, it's very wrinkly. So it doesn't look pretty. There are a lot of fixes. You see those sticks there. That's because the wing broke off and things like that. But ugly as it may be, it still has flown. The one that has flown the most of the models that I've done. So let me put in the battery and let's try something with it. So I'm calling it a day now. Also, with the Spitfire, actually it flew quite nicely. It took a bit of a try, but then in the end, if you can observe, my elevator came out and I can't pull the hinge out, so I need some tools to fix it. But it did fly quite nicely, quite docilely. I'm not sure how much I got on camera, as usual. So let's see if there's anything that is worth posting, but happy with the Spitfire. It's going to be a comeback always to it. Not as good as the P51, of course, but happy with it. So I can recommend any conversion of the little Guillo Spitfire. And there's the mosquito from earlier on. So in any case, thank you everybody for watching, and I'll see you next time.